Hi, and welcome back to my stories on how I started a food business. Today's topic is suppliers and sourcing ingredients. The first thing to know is that quality food requires quality raw materials. So to achieve food safety, you must make sure you work hard in getting food suppliers that you deal with consistently. The first thing to do is to go around your menu, examine the recipes, what are the materials that you think you require to produce the food that you're cooking. Once you've ascertained this material, make a list and then approach either your local cash and carry, your local market, street market, grocer or supermarket, or even online shops. Google it up and check the material and see who is out there selling such material. The next thing to do is to establish a list of who you think you want to deal with. In selecting suppliers, you are expected to choose ones that are reputable, the ones that you are sure will give you a guaranteed supply of quality raw material. The other thing to do is not just to run around buying here and there. After you've selected the supplier that you think you want to work with, keep a list of them in your company, write a supplier list, write their telephone number, their contact details, and what you receive from them or what you buy from them. Once you've done that, you can now begin to order from these suppliers. The other area that I'd like to mention is monitoring suppliers. Do not give the control of your supply to your suppliers. Monitor what they supply you, because if they notice, like every other person, if you know that this person is not diligent, they can supply you rubbish. I remember when we first started, we had the delivery of margarine, and if we're not diligent, we would have taken on board expired goods, but because the margarine had already expired, but it was a way of that supplier, you know, dumping SS things that they don't know who to sell it to people who are coming into the business new. So make sure that you are aware of these things, check the date, the batch, and make sure that all the supply that come in are in good state. You can do this by creating something called incoming goods record. We have incoming goods record. I talked about that when I was teaching on HACCP principles. The incoming goods record is where you write down what suppliers deliver to you, write down the name of that ingredient or material, write down the date and the batch date and the expiry date on that delivery. Keep the records for due diligence, and also it will come in useful for traceability, because when you operate in a food business, you have to have a recall policy in place. This is what your company has written down as the last resort of what to do should something go wrong with your food. So if you have incoming goods record, you will translate that incoming goods record into something called traceability record. The traceability record is just a way of identifying every product that comes in contact with customers at the end of the day, starting from ingredients that go into your food, the food you produce, the date you produce, the batch that you produce, and what you supply to your customers. So if at all anything goes wrong, you can follow through the traceability record to see who you think would have such batch that has gone wrong. So this is the reason why you keep records. The final thing to do is also, after you've done all the written down the suppliers, you should also ask them for discounts. You can ask them for bulk discounts. You can ask them for, you can negotiate credit with them as well. Like, for instance, some of our suppliers will be giving us 28 days. So, for instance, if you order maybe a pallet of oil from KTC, for instance, you can pay them after 28 days. So, this will help your cash flow. It will help you manage your accounting better as well. So, I hope I've been able to help in this episode of suppliers and sourcing ingredients. I will see you again in the next episode. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.